Everything is about balance in our world, specifically in our bodies. The system that protects this balance is called homeostasis. For example, a substance in our blood should be in a specific concentration. If the concentration goes higher for any reason, our body tries to activate or deactivate mechanisms that decrease the concentration to the normal range. If something happens and this system can't maintain this balance, we are gonna have problems. If you look at the bone tissue, which is mostly made of collagen matrix and hydroxyapatite, the density of the bone should be in a specific range. If it goes higher, we call this osteopetrosis or stone bone disease. If it goes lower than the balance concentration, it would be osteoporosis or brittle bones. To understand this phenomenon, first you need to know that there are two unique cells in our bone tissue. One is osteoblasts, which produce the bone by secreting bone matrix, and the other is osteoclasts, which break down the bone by releasing acid. There is a balance between the population of these two cells, which has control over bone density. Now, if this balance disrupts and the population of osteoclasts increases, the rate of breaking down the bone would be higher compared to making the bone. Therefore, it would result in lower bone density and cause osteoporosis. However, if the population of osteoblasts increases compared to osteoclasts, it would cause osteopetrosis. Okay, now the question is, how exactly do these cell populations change over time? Controlling any cell population requires controlling the rate of birth and death of cells, and some mechanisms control the programmed cell death, proliferation, and differentiation of stem cells into osteoblasts and osteoclasts. These mechanisms are complex and involve a lot of molecules. However, they can be divided in two different categories. The first one is the direct cell-cell communication between osteoblasts and osteoclasts. In addition, they can communicate with soluble factor, which could be local or systematic. I'm not going through all of them because we're going to find ourselves talking about a lot of molecules, which I think is a boring way of learning biology, and I prefer to get back to them when we want to talk about them specifically. However, I can get you an example to show you how it works. If you look at the data, menopause in women significantly speeds up bone loss and increases the risk of osteoporosis. Approximately 1 in 10 women over the age of 60 are affected by osteoporosis worldwide, and it happens because of a hormonal change, which is characterized by dropping the level of estrogen. So what happens when the estrogen level drops? A study by Melville and colleagues showed that the deletion of the estrogen receptors on osteoclasts in female mice would decrease bone volume due to an increase in the number of osteoclasts. However, this deletion in male mice does not alter bone mass. If you delete this exact gene in osteoblasts of female mice, it would dramatically decrease the cancellous and cortical bone mass due to a reduction in osteoblast activity. Another study showed that this deletion in mesenchymal stem cells decreases the population and differentiation of these cells to osteoblasts, and also it would suppress the osteoclast differentiation by blocking a very famous signaling pathway called the Rankel pathway. Plus, estrogen can induce osteoclast apoptosis, so you can see how a low level of estrogen can decrease bone mass dramatically. Besides all of these factors, the fun part starts when we can understand that the immune cells play a really important role. For example, neutrophils, which are the first line of defense, can increase the population of osteoclasts by releasing these factors. We talked about macrophages before, which can be polarized into two types, M1 and M2 macrophages. The M1 macrophages increase the inflammation and the osteoclast population by releasing these factors. However, the M2 macrophages release immunomodulatory cytokines such as growth factors and interleukin-10 that increase the osteoblast population. The T cells would differentiate into three other T cells. One is called CD4 or T helper cells, and the other is CD8 or cytotoxic T cells. Both of them release TNF-alpha and interferon gamma, which increase the population of osteoclasts. However, the regulatory T cells or Tregs would secrete interleukin-10 and growth factors that increase osteoblasts. We can see the same effect by B cells. They can differentiate into IgM memory B cells, which increase the bone mass by producing interleukin-10 molecules. In the next video, we are going to talk about how our body can make bones, but until then, thank you for watching.